Good Monday evening, everybody. Live and direct from House Onek in Memphis, Tennessee. I'm meteorologist Austen Onek with a complete update of your forecast, looking into the course of the rest of the next several days. We've got some fairly quiet weather out there and also not looking at too much of any other major problems for the Mid-South until about mid to late week. We'll talk about that coming up here in just a little bit. Beautiful Monday evening in progress. A few clouds around, but otherwise not really seeing too much of any other major concerns out there for the rest of the evening. So good news on that. Questions, concerns, comments, ideas, you can see again, Wright should not have worn the Red Sox jersey with the white colors. You can see the email address right here at austen.onek@wreg.com. If you have anything you'd like to see on here specifically, let me know, and we'll be glad to give you an idea as to what's happening around the Mid-South, whether it's climate or worldwide weather. Let me know, and we'll be glad to post it on here for you. We'll take a look at river levels. We'll take a look at where the next storm system is going to be coming from, and we'll take a look at your forecast into the rest of the week. Currently, let's take a look and see what's going on with traffic in the Mid-South. We do have, again, a decent amount of slowdowns and backups taking place into and around the area of Mount Moriah. Some slowdowns from the entrance of 385 from 240 eastbound into that area, and looks like, again, that's going to be probably a little ways in getting that backed up, taken care of, and out of the picture, because as of right now, we're just not seeing anything in the way of traffic really moving along very well. Kirby and Riverdale, looks like traffic is down to the teens miles per hour in that location, and also seeing, again, some slow conditions down towards Shelby Drive with another accident at Shelby Drive and Tuggle Road, and also at Holmes Road east at Pleasant Hill Road. So some decent amounts of accident there. Also an accident on Poplar at Colonial reported just a little while ago. So again, this is something that may have to deal with on your way home for later on tonight. So something to keep an eye on at that location. Let's go ahead and see what's going on across the area. We have one storm system on its way out. We're located in the green circle that you see in the middle portion of your screen. Large swoop of energy back to our east is looking again at the possibility of some areas of rainfall at this time, but we will see again the possibility of some more showers coming our way with our next storm system getting going, and part of that is visible back to our southwest over the southwestern United States. Large loop of energy making its way on through that location and moving up into around Colorado. Some pretty big thunderstorms taking place there. We'll be watching that as it gets a little bit closer to us by week's end, along with a little bit more energy coming our way as we look even farther back to around the Pacific Northwest. That is going to help to, again, make its way in and develop a little bit more in the chances of showers and thunderstorms. But for us, the possibilities should be limited, so looking very good on that. Currently, we're not seeing anything in the way of active weather across the Mid-South. The National Weather Service is, again, showing the main thing in the green-shaded categories, flood advisories over toward the Tennessee River. And these that you see just right up here into around the black, the Cache, the White, the St. Francis, and the Mississippi rivers up and down the screen, those are flood warnings for, again, sustained warnings. This is not a flash flood warning where the water appears instantaneously. This is all that drainage from that moisture we got over a week ago, which is doing a very good job of keeping, again, a lot of roads underwater in parts of northeast Arkansas. So you may want to think about calling ahead, checking your destination before you travel into or through any of these areas and areas around the Mississippi River. Again, this is not going to be inundating downtown Memphis or anything. Didn't even do that back in 2011. It did cause a lot of problems, but it wasn't going to be anything like that. This is not going to be anywhere close to the 2011 floods, but it is still going to be causing a lot of problems. So definitely want to call ahead, check your destination, and see if you can see what's going on out there before you get on the way, because that may save you a lot of problems as you get into the course of the next couple of days. Remember, turn around, don't drown, find another way to get to where you're going. Great opportunity to make sure that you stay safe into anywhere across the area or around the world. No matter where you go to, never drive through water-covered roadways. It's just not a good idea. Here's what it looks like on the national map. Again, high pressure well in control of the Mid-South area, and you can tell almost it's a little bit more humid out here. We've got moisture coming in from off the Gulf of Mexico, rotating around that area of high pressure counterclockwise, and then our next storm system sitting off into around the area just right here into around portions of the desert southwest. That's going to be, again, making its way into our area and giving us the potential of some more problems out across the Mid-South where it comes to rainfall. We'll talk about that coming up here in just a little bit. What does it look like in our area? Well, let's take a look right now at earthquakes. We did not have anything in the last 24 hours directly in the Mid-South. One was just north of the area, and that was a 2.3 yesterday afternoon at about 4:21. And another one reported yesterday evening, just about 10:30, a 2.0 northwest of Jonesboro, back up around the Walnut Ridge area. So we did manage to get some close to the area, but otherwise the New Madrid Fault has been very quiet in the last 24 hours, and here's hoping it stays that way. Want to see more of our webcams available? WREG.com/webcams if you'd like to find out more about what it looks like out there. Cotton Exchange camera focused in on the river and keeping track as to what's going on in and around the Mid-South to keep you updated with what's happening. And as of right now, it looks like things are quiet in that location. Traffic on the heavy side around the area of St. Francis and Cordova. So hopefully, again, everybody getting home. And again, that's WREG.com/webcams for more information there. On the flooding side of things, again, the flooding situation is not as bad as it could be from where we were looking at back in about 2011 or so. We may see, again, the potential of some more flooding. The river is still rising coming up this direction. And as soon as the Advanced Hydrologic Prediction Service gives me the page, we'll get to that coming up here in just a little bit. Hopefully, I'll go ahead and take a look at radar at this time and show you what we've got going on. Netcasting, it happens. Sorry about that. Rainfall down toward the hill country of Texas and into around the Rio Grande, but really just not that much happening. Again, directly for the Mid-South. Let's see, are you working yet? Yeah, there we go. Okay, cool. Now, this is a great website to go to get more information as to what's going on where it comes to flooding in a particular location. Now, again, here in the Mid-South area, we have several areas under flooding at this time. You can take a look at many different rivers and streams, all thanks to this one website. You can go to water.weather.gov for more information, and a great place to go to for more details. You see most of the purple and red categories. That's major flooding and moderate flooding taking place around areas close to the White River, around the Cache River at Patterson, and of course back toward the Mississippi River, where we have numerous amounts of flooding going on, and that's where we're seeing that surge of water making its way downstream, and that's going to be getting a little bit closer to the Memphis area. This is what it looks like in and around Osceola. The information again showing that crest heading into the purple shade of the major flooding that's 35 feet and above on the Mississippi River at Osceola, Arkansas. That crest is going to be happening, it looks like, less than a week from now, toward about this next Friday into next Saturday, and then that surge is going to be heading downwards as we get a little bit closer to around Memphis by week's end and into next weekend. Now, so far, again, it does not look to be a major threat. The National Weather Service and the Advanced Hydrologic Prediction Center did a good job of doing a new forecast, and it shows that we're only going to be in minor flood stage, but that's going to take it up to 36 and a half feet by the time we get to around next Friday and Saturday, and then afterwards everything drops back on down again. But it's going to take a while for that surge of water to make its way down the Mississippi River. It's going to make its way through. It's on the way down to the Gulf of Mexico, but it's just going to take a while for all that stuff to make its way on out of here. What's the weather look like right now? Again, our latest storm system on the way from the West Coast states, and it's going to be impacting the Rockies and the desert southwest first. We'll have high pressure and control for much of the rest of the week, but then as we get into around Wednesday night into Thursday, showers and thunderstorms off to the west, and that begins to give us a little bit more problems where it comes to chances of showers and thunderstorms getting a little bit closer to where we are. Let's go ahead and take a look and see what's going on with the forecast as we get into, again, today into tonight. Beautiful day today, no problems at all. Getting into tonight, low temperatures will be dropping their way back on down into around the, let's see, once again, we're having some problems here. Sorry about that. Looks like we have a bit of a connection difficulty. We'll go ahead. Okay, is this going to work? Okay, there we go. Sorry about the delays on that. Temperatures back into around the mid to upper 50s to lower 60s across much of the area tonight. Should be mostly clear, and overnight temperatures with those winds out there relatively light. No wind chills to worry about, not even close to that. Temperatures for tomorrow will be back into the mid 80s once again, so very pleasant and plenty of sunshine there. Winds will be continuing out of the southwest and continuing at about 5 to 10 miles per hour with minimal wind gusts out there, 10 to 15 miles per hour times, really just not much more than that. Let's take a look into Tuesday night. Low temperatures dropping to the upper 50s to the lower to mid 60s, especially the mid 60s into and around the area for the Shelby County, Memphis metro area coming up for Tuesday night into Wednesday. Wednesday, we see again temperatures even warmer back in the mid to upper 80s in some locations, and winds will continue out of the southwest at about 10 to 15 miles per hour, and that could be a little bit on the breezy side, but we're still not seeing anything in the way of rainfall, at least just yet. yet, but the chances of rain will be making their way into northwestern parts of the viewing area as we get into around areas close to 1 o'clock Thursday morning. That's where we see, again, the chances of showers begin and going to overspread the area. Let's see about low temperatures on Wednesday back in the 60s pretty much for everybody, and then high temperatures on Thursday back in the lower 80s with best chance of rainfall northwestern parts of the viewing area, northeast Arkansas, the Boot Heel, and just west of northwest Tennessee, and temperatures throughout the afternoon very much on the mild side, but we will be seeing more chances of showers and thunderstorms moving their way in by Thursday and also into Thursday night. That will overspread most of the area with lows dropping to the lower to mid-60s and showers and thunderstorms pretty much a guarantee for almost everybody in the Mid-South by late Thursday into very early on Friday. High temperatures on Friday will be a little bit cooler thanks to the cloud cover and the rainfall out there. We're not going to be seeing too much of anything in the way of warmer conditions across the Mid-South, and temperatures along with that rain will continue throughout the day, and it looks like it'll be finally winding up as we go toward Friday night. Low temperatures, very nice after that rain moves on out and skies begin to clear back into the mid-50s or so. So no problems being seen there. Severe weather, again, not staying anywhere close to the Mid-South. It's all going to be out to our west, but there is going to be that possibility that we could see some severe weather as we get into around late Thursday night. That area that you see there, the possibility of, again, some showers and thunderstorms becoming severe on Thursday evening into around Friday. Let me see if I can stop the animation here for just a second. And okay, you're going to hold there. Okay, good. There we go. That is what we're looking at right there. The possibility of severe weather coming up from basically Memphis on down into the Arklatex area, but we still see that potential of some severe weather to look at. And again, it's not huge right now, but that's something, again, we would need to watch with a lot of interest over the next couple of days. Tonight, tomorrow, and Wednesday, no major problems being seen whatsoever, but we see, again, that potential for more problems as we go into Thursday. We'll be watching that with a lot of interest, and so should you. So stay tuned for more on that with News Channel 3. Should be able to catch an iridium flare fairly easily for tonight. Well, again, my computer having a little bit of issues out there, but look to the east, southeast at about 9:36 for a point of light to fade into view and then to fade back out again as we go into the rest of the evening hours. We'll talk more about that in my astronomy blog, Sky Blog 3. Don't forget, you can check out astronomy as well, and tons of science information available on my Twitter page. That's available from twitter.com/aonic_WREG. And tons of information also available on my Facebook page at facebook.com/AustenOnek, WREG. And check out a bunch more information available out there as well. And we'll keep you informed on that. Again, for later on tonight, if we have the opportunity to take a look around at what's going on in the skies across the Mid-South, that's where we should see, again, the potential of some hopefully good sky-gazing conditions. The Moon and Jupiter, beautiful last night, should be looking good again tonight. We'll keep you updated on that. So stay tuned for more there. Again, questions, concerns, comments, and ideas. It's kind of bright with the glare and the white shirt right here, but if you can see a little bit more about what it looks like right here, let me see if this helps a little bit. Okay, there you go. Austen.Onek@WREG, excuse me, again.com. And you can send me information about what's going on. If you missed it, forecast information in the blue bar here, social media information at the red bar at the bottom of the page, where you can find me on all these icons, social medias out there, and we'll keep you informed here on News Channel 3. That'll wrap it up for this edition of News Channel 3's exclusive video weather blog, Weather Overtime. I'll have more coming up tonight online with News Channel 3, and of course, Tim and Jim will have more on News Channel 3 at 6 and 10, and Todd Demers bright and early tomorrow morning on News Channel 3 Daybreak. Thanks for joining me for an extended version of our exclusive video weather blog, Weather Overtime, and stay tuned to News Channel 3 on air and online for more information about the Mid-South forecast.